So the next topic we are going to explain about the spherical mirror. Spherical. First of all, what is spherical mirror? A reflecting surface which is a part of a sphere. So this is a part of a sphere. Sphere means a circle. Okay. So students, it is very very important topic, and I will give you one clue, one hint, which is which makes help you to understand this topic. Okay, very easy topic. And first of all, this is a this mirror is a part of sphere. One is silver from inside, one is silver from outside. Okay, so it is of two part. So reflecting surface which is a part of a sphere is called as a spherical mirror. Okay, now types of mirror, two types of mirror are there we are having. One is a concave and one is a convex. See, I am writing, in my writing only you can come to know about the name of the mirror. This is convex mirror. X I have put little big. Why? The reason is this. X, that means we can shade this X. That means which part comes? Inside part. That means convex mirror is that mirror which is silvered from the inner side. Convex mirror is that mirror which is silvered from the inside. And opposite another one is called as concave. Concave means outside. Okay, so this is concave side and this is convex. This is convex mirror which is silvered from the inside, and this is concave which is silvered from the outside, and this is bulge from the, that means reflection is should be at the outside. Reflection is at the outside. Okay, reflection. And here in the concave it can converging, it is a converging mirror. Converging means it bends the rays, it converges the rays, and this means diverging. Convex, the another name of the convex mirror is called as diverging. Diverging mirror. And concave, the another name of the concave mirror is called as converging. Converging means it converges the rays. Okay, it collect the rays and focus at one point. Okay, so these are the two main mirror are there, concave and convex. So its main part, technical terms are there. First one is a center of curvature. All mirrors are the part of sphere. So center of the sphere is called as center of the sphere of the mirror is called as the center of curvature. Okay, so center of curvature is the mirror, is the center of the sphere in which the mirror is a part. Mirror ek uska hissa hai. Okay, so second one is radius of curvature. That means radius of the sphere in which the mirror is a part, that is called as radius of curvature. As I told you that it is a part of a sphere. Okay, all the definition, all the technical terms you have to relate with the sphere only, my dear students. Okay, so next one is a pole. Pole means the geometrical center of the sphere. Geometrical center. So this is the geometrical center of the sphere. So geometrical center of the spherical surface of the mirror is called as pole. This is called as pole. Okay, this is a sphere. This much is only the sphere. This is a sphere. So center one is called as pole. This is called as pole. Then aperture. Aperture means where the total surface, the plane surface area of the mirror through which the light rays enter. From this point, the light is entering into the mirror. Okay, fall on the mirror. That is called as aperture. Okay, so then principal axis. Principal axis means the straight line which joining the pole and the center of curvature is called as principal axis. Okay, the joining the pole of the mirror to the center of the curvature is called as principal axis. Now focus and a focal length. Focus, फोकस मीन्स वेयर ऑल रेस टूगेदर मीट एट वन पॉइंट. ओके दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द फोकस ऑफ ए कॉनकेव मिरर इज अ पॉइंट ऑन द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस. कहां पे होगा ये फोकस? ऑन द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस थ्रू विच द लाइट रेस इंसिडेंट पैरेलल द रेस विच कम्स पैरेलल ऑल रेस आर पैरेलल टू ईच अदर. ओके एंड आफ्टर रिफ्लेक्शन फ्रॉम दिस इट मीट एट वन पॉइंट एंड दैट पॉइंट इज कॉल्ड एज ए फोकस पॉइंट. दिस द रेज ऑल रेज आर कमिंग पैरेलल फ्रॉम द सन ऑल रेज आर कमिंग पैरेलल एंड इफ यू पुट ए मिरर इन फ्रंट ऑफ द सनलाइट देन इट विल फोकस एट वन पॉइंट. ओके द शाइनिंग लाइट विल बी एट वन पॉइंट दैट मीन ऑल द रेज आर मीटिंग एट दिस पॉइंट सो दिस पॉइंट इज कॉल्ड एज फोकस पॉइंट. ओके कनकेव कनकेव इज कन्वर्जिंग ऑल रेज आर कन्वर्ज्ड एंड फोकस एट वन पॉइंट दैट इज कॉल्ड एज ए कन्वर्ज फोकस पॉइंट. सो सेम वे विद द कन्वेक्स मिरर इज ए पॉइंट ऑन द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस फ्रॉम विच द लाइट इज इंसिडेंट पैरेलल टू द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस एंड अपीयर टू कम इन द कन्वेक्स मिरर ऑलवेज यू हैव टू यूज देयर अपीयर टू डाइवर्ज और अपीयर टू कम. ओके आफ्टर रिफ्लेक्शन फ्रॉम द मिरर बिकॉज दोज ऑलवेज वी विल हैव ए इन ए कन्वेक्स मिरर always it gives a virtual image the rays are not at one point so it will gives a virtual so we can use the word appear to come they try to come at that point that is called as a convex mirror or focus mirror, focus of a, and that convex mirror so focal point the parallel beam of light inclined to the principal axis get focused parallel beam ऑफ लाइट जो प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस के ऊपर फोकस कर रही है एट दिस प्लेन दैट इज कॉल्ड एज फोकल पॉइंट. ओके नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक बिकॉज वी आर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन दैट ड्रॉ द डायग्राम्स. सो बिफोर ड्रॉइंग द डायग्राम्स यू शुड नो द प्रिंसिपल और रूल्स टू कंस्ट्रक्ट द डायग्राम्स ऑफ इमेज बाय द रे डायग्राम. सो देर आर फोर रूल्स आर देयर. First of all, what are the four rules? According to the rules, we will construct the diagrams. Because if you know the rules, then it is easy for you to understand the this diagrams. First of all, what is this ray? This is the principal axis. This is the pole. Okay, and this is a concave mirror. Okay. The ray which comes parallel to the principal axis and this is the center of curvature. This is the center of curvature or we can say focus point. This is the center of curvature, this is the focus point. Okay. This is the focus point and this is the center of curvature. The first thing is the ray which comes parallel to the principal axis, where it reflect back. It always reflect back through the focus point. It always reflect back through the focus point. The second one is the ray which pass from the center of curvature, from where it reflect back. This the ray which is incident through the center of curvature, from where it reflect back. It reflect back by their own axis, by their own axis where it comes the path. From which it comes the same way back to its same path. This is the second rule. And the third rule is the ray which is fall at the pole. The ray which is fall at the pole. This is a pole. From where it goes back, it obey the law of reflection. It obey the law. That means whatever the angle of incidence, same as the angle of reflection. Okay, so these are the two or three rules are there. Second one, the ray passing through the center of curvature, then it goes reflect its own path. Second, the ray parallel to the principal axis, it passes from the focus. Third, a ray passing through the focus, yes. The ray passing through the focus If the ray reflected through the focus, that means the incident from parallel. Now, the ray which passed from the focus, it reflected parallel to the principal axis. So, these are the four rules which we can apply by drawing the, by constructing the ray diagram. Okay, so understood? Now, the very important topic which I am going to explain you, that is the first one is, let us explain these six diagrams are there. And six diagram, I used to say that it is the important case. Okay, that is the important case that we will discuss later. Now, the first one we are going to discuss about the, this is the pole, this is the focus, this is the center of curvature. When the object is at infinity, that means we doesn't know that where is the object is lying. Now, where the object is at infinity, okay. So, where is the focus point? Now, the ray which is parallel to the principal axis, it passing through the focus. Now, the we will get what type of characteristics is this. Characteristics are very, very important, students. Okay, and I told you that always concave mirror always gives real inverted. Real and inverted, always it gives two characteristics are there, always real and inverted. That's why I told that this is the special case. This is a special case. So, this is different. Here, the this rule will be different. Okay. So, now firstly, what type of characteristics? It gives real, inverted and diminished. Diminished means very small. Very small image it will give. The second one is when the object is at far point or at beyond the center of curvature. This is focus, this is C. Now beyond the center, object is on the line, but it is beyond the center of curvature. Okay, now understood. Listen, first way is it always parallel to the principal. One ray is parallel to the principal axis. Second, it which is the first point? Center of curvature. So one ray will pass from the center of curvature. These two are the incident ray. So the ray which is parallel to the principal axis, from where it will reflect back through the focus. Second, the ray which is incident to the center of curvature, from where it reflect back its own axis. Students, the arrow should be there. Without arrow, you will not get marks. Okay, incident ray. Now, the incident ray, the, so where the rays meet at this point, this is the image. So what are the characteristics over here? It is real, inverted and below the principal axis. So highly diminished. Okay, so characteristics are real, inverted and third one is it is highly diminished. Diminished. Okay, now the third one is this is focus. Now the image with the object will comes close to the this mirror. Okay, now it is at center of curvature. Before that it is beyond the center of curvature. Now at the center of curvature, one line is passing through the parallel. One line is parallel. Second one, which is the next point to the center of curvature? Focus. So second, it will pass from the center of focus. Now the ray which is parallel to the principal axis, it reflects back through the focus. And second, the ray which is passing through the center of through the focus, it will back to the center of curvature. Okay. Parallel to the principal axis. So where this rays will meet, it will meet at exactly under the image. Exactly under the image. That means now here in this case the real inverted and very special, it is same as the size of the image object, same as size of the object. जितना object का size था उतना ही size image का बन गया. Okay, this is the third case. And now in the fourth case, so now the image will come in between the center of curvature and the focus point. So one is parallel and second one, what is the next? This is the focus point. Okay, focus point. Now the ray which is parallel, it comes to the focus point and this is parallel. So here it will be what type of? Now it will be not be the diminished. Now it will be the next magnified. Okay, now image will be magnified. So what type of image will be there? Real inverted and magnified. Now it will be magnified, badi hoti jayegi. Okay, now next one is a when the image is at F, object is at F. Now object is at F. Okay, now one is parallel. Any other point is there next to this one? No. So we can pass from this, we can pass from the center of curvature. Next reflected ray we can pass from the incident ray, sorry, we can pass from the center of curvature. Okay, now the ray which is passing from the center of curvature, it comes back in the same path. Next one, this one is then to the this side to, through the focus. Now what type of image? It can be meet at very far point. This can be meet. Okay, this can be meet at this very far point. So we can write this is real inverted and highly magnified. Bahut badi ho jayegi. Highly magnified. Okay, type of images will be there. Characteristics. Now this is the special case. Why I give the special case? Because it has a different characteristics. You will get a different characteristics. Now image, where is the, first of all, where is the object? Object is between the pole and the focus. Okay, pole and the focus. Now one is parallel. Any another is there? It can pass through the, we can pass through the center of curvature. Okay, so this will be reflect back through the focus and this will be same. This will not be meet. This will not meet. Okay, now where the image will be there, then image will be behind the mirror. Behind the mirror, it will be at this point. So this line should be not be straight line, it should be dotted. Okay, and if you draw a straight line, the mark can be cut over here. Okay, so this is the image, this is A and this is B. This is A dash, this can be A dash and this can be B dash. Okay, so what type of characteristics is there? The characteristics can be not be real. Opposite to real is virtual. It can be inverted? No, it can be upright. All the characteristics can be changed in this special case. And third one is, it is magnified. So concave always give, always give real inverted. Can we write this one? No, in special case only it can give a virtual, upright and magnified. 5 k's. So students, these 6 ray diagrams are very, very, very important topics. So 2-3 times, not 1 or 2, 2-3 times you have to draw and write the characteristics of this diagram, and you can explain or you can ask to me in the comment section if you have a doubt. Then sign convention is not in the syllabus. Formula for the spherical mirror is not in the syllabus. And last topic is uses of concave mirror. Small topic, it is, we can use as a shaving mirror. We can use a concave mirror used as a reflector. At doctor's head also using the concave mirror. Convex mirror are using by the rear view mirror. So distinction are there. So try to read this topic and understand. And if you have a doubt, you can frankly ask to me. Thank you.